So in last class we have solved the economics dispatch problem or economic dispatch problem formulation with inclusion of the losses, transmission losses. So we included the losses also, and we come up with some equations and how to find out power generator including the losses. We come up with this values. So today we are going to form an algorithm to find out the optimized power scheduling by including with the inclusion of the losses. So we'll call this as algorithm for economic dispatch with losses. So with losses. So for this first step is step 1. What is step 1? As usual, what we need to find? Find lambda. So here lambda is equal to, here lambda is equal to nothing but PD plus summation of I is equal to 1 to n BI divided by 2CI whole divided by summation of I is equal to 1 to n and 1 divided by 2CI. So this is the lambda form. So first we are going to find out the lambda, and second step, step 2, we are going to assume PGI, that is the power generated at initial state, is equal to 0 for all generators. I is equal to 1, 2, 3 for all generators. We are going to assume at the first, during the first iteration, we are going to assume 0. So this is the first assumption we are making. And then step 3. So step 3 is nothing but to solve PGI. Solve PGI. So what is PGI formula? Last class we derived the PGI. So same PGI we need to take here. So PGI is nothing but 1 minus BI by lambda minus 2. This you should memorize. J is equal to 1 and J is not equal to I to n Pij Pgj. We derived this yesterday, and 2Ci divided by lambda plus 2BII. Just we removed or separated the ith element from this summation and we just got this Pg value. So we need to solve this. This is the step 3. And then going to step 4. Step 4 is check the equality constraints. Inequality constraints.
So minus 3, minus 4 is 1. Now come to 3 and 4.
So what are all the inequality constraints here? We know that this power generated for the every generator must be equal to or lesser than equal to the PG I min and then PG I max. So this is called inequality constraint, because there is no any equal, maybe greater than this or equal to this and lesser than this and equal to this. So this is how our generation should be there. If the calculated value at step 3 is violating this condition, then there will be two chances we will get. So what are those chances of violating? Maybe if PGI can be greater than this PGI, PG min, this PGI, sorry, this PGI may be lesser than this PGI min, then what we need to do? We need to fix PGI is equal to PGI min. So as usual, we are same thing we did for excluding the losses also. So same thing we need to do for inequality constraints. And one more chance is this Pgi may be greater than this Pgi max. So this is next condition. Then fix this Pgi is equal to Pgi max. So this is the fixing variable, fixing this Pgi. So this is how we fixed for excluding the losses also, right? So next step is we need to calculate the transmission losses. Step 5 is to calculate the transmission losses. So how to do that? We have the formula to find out the transmission losses. There's nothing but PL is equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to n and then summation of j is equal to 1 to n. Because there are we are considering different generators, right, for losses. Maybe one generator in one plant and maybe another generator in another plant. So we are taking I is equal to 1 to n and j is equal to 1 to n, and then the power generated by the ith bus and Pij, that is nothing but loss coefficient matrix, and then this is Pgj. So we need to find out this PL by solving this equation. Then just a minute, I will add some pages.
So next class Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform and continuous time Fourier transform.
So this is step 5, and step 6 is check the power balance equation. We know what is the power balance equation. So step 6 is check the power balance equation. So what is power balance equation? Power balance equation is nothing but the sum of the power generated must be equal to the demand plus loss, because power of this is the demand and this is loss. So this generator should be equal to the sum of this demand plus loss. So then only this power balance equation will be satisfied. So we need to check that, and if it is satisfying, then we can tell that is the optimized value. Otherwise, step 7, if it is violating this condition, power balance equation, then we need to tune again with some other thing. We need to increase the lambda value. We need to increase the lambda value by del lambda. So we need to change this lambda into del lambda by increasing it if the summation of Pgi minus Pd, that is the power balance equation. So if I take these two things inside and make it as 0, then I will get Pgi minus Pd minus PL is greater than 0. If it is greater than 0, then this is the condition we need to make. That is, we need to increase the lambda value, and then we need to update the lambda as del lambda. Otherwise, we need to decrease the lambda value by new lambda if my summation of Pgi minus Pd minus PL is greater than 0. So we need to decrease the lambda. So by this we can update with the new lambda, and then by getting this new lambda value, we need to repeat step 3 till getting the optimized solution. So till getting your optimized solution, we need to repeat the step. So with this new delta value, we need to go to the step 3 and repeat that value. So this is how we need to take this as the algorithm to solve the economic dispatch problem when losses are included. Any doubt up to this? Any doubt?
Sir?
Yes. Yes, ma, tell some.
Sir.
Yes, ma, tell ma.
Sir, the condition is both greater, sir.
Where, which step, ma?
Sir, if the condition, if we decrease the lambda, the condition is 7 step, last step.
Okay, okay. Some step I will increase.
You have given both the condition as greater.
No. The arrow mark, please see the arrow mark. This is decreasing. This is increasing. So we need to increase the lambda value if this power balance equation is greater than 0. We need to increase the lambda. And increased lambda is change in lambda, that is nothing but del. And if this condition, power balance equation condition is, I understand your point. Yeah, I understand. This is lesser than, sorry, this is a mistake. So this is lesser than 0. Good. So yeah, that is correct. If it is lesser than 0, then this condition. Yeah, I understand your problem. Thank you. So now, any doubt? Any doubt? Any other doubt? Any other question? This is correct. What she said is correct. Here, this is lesser than 0. Any other doubt? Yes or no, please. Okay. Next, with this algorithm, we come up with set of equations, or we know how to find out some values according to the questions we are given. So for that, to start the practice of solving, we'll have a questions. I will take a problem 5 now. This is the 5th problem in module 3. So problem 5, the note down. So what do you understand from this question? The incremental cost of two generating plants. So there are two generating plants and they are given incremental cost for each generator plants, and they are telling the system is operating on economic dispatch. Already it is economic only or optimized only. So already it is optimized, and optimized values are PG1, PG2 is equal to 100 megawatts. So it is the optimum value they have already mentioned. And they have given DPL by DPG2. So what is this DPL by DPG2? Any idea? What is this ITC? Any idea? Incremental transmission loss, right? Or incremental, what is this ITC? Just recall where we solved the ITC. Anyone have written the notes? So that is nothing but ITCL is nothing but what? Any idea? So DPL by DPGI. So this is nothing but incremental transmission loss they have given. So in this question, incremental transmission loss for plant 2. So the plant 2 they have given. We need to find penalty factor. Penalty factor is nothing but L1 for the plant 1. Penalty factor is L1. And what is the formula for penalty factor? I'll make this as in blue because this is the solution. This is also solution. In the part of solution, we identify this is nothing but incremental transmission loss for the plant 2. And then we need to find L1. And what is the formula for this L1? L1 is nothing but 1 by 1 minus ITL 1. For 1 means this is 1. We need to find this. So understand the question. We need to find out the penalty factor for power plant 1. So solution. Solution for that is, we know that the incremental cost given ITL2 is equal to 0.2. This is given. And also from this given value, we can able to find out the penalty factor for plant 2. So penalty factor for plant 2 is nothing but 1 divided by 1 minus ITL1. So what is the value for this? 1 divided by 1 minus 0.2. What is the value? You will get 1.2. So this is the penalty factor for plant 2. But we need to find out for plant 1. So to find out for plant 1, let me start by assuming L1 is equal to del 1 is equal to del 2, because we know that if it is optimum, because in the question they are telling it is already optimum. So if it is optimum, then delta 1 will be equal to delta 2, then only it will be optimum by this assumption or this condition. And also we know del I is nothing but ICI, incremental cost of this I, into the penalty factor. So if you multiply these two, I will get this lambda. If that is the case, this lambda 1 is nothing but IC1 multiplication of L1 is equal to IC2 multiplication of L2, right? Then we know IC1 is given here, and this is nothing but the incremental cost. So in question they have given the incremental cost. So this is IC1 and this is IC2, because it is given in the question. From this I can write IC1 is 20.0.1 PG1 into L1. So if you recall, this is what we need to find out, right? This is what we need to find out. This is known and this is calculated, already calculated, and this is given, this is also given. So only unknown is this L1 we need to find out. So and IC2 is also given, is nothing but 22.5 plus 0, 22.5 plus 0.15 PG2 multiplication of this L2 we find out 1.25. So if you solve this, I will get L1 is equal to 1.5625. So this is the penalty factor for my plant 1. Any doubt? So this is the solution. Any doubt? Any doubt? Why? Because this PG1 is given and this PG2 also given. What is the PG1, PG2 value? Someone tell me. What is PG1, PG2 value? Please tell me what is PG1, PG2 value, at least by seeing the question.
100.
So 100. So it is given. This is nothing but 100 and this is also nothing but 100. So if you solve this, we will get the value L1. Any doubt? Please tell me. Any doubt? Up to this, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So next question, problem 6. So these are all simple questions. Because of that, I am going a little bit fast. In a system consisting a two generating units connected to transmission line. TL means transmission line. The ICs. ICs means what? What is ICs? Incremental cost. ICs are DF1 divided by DP1 is equal to 0.16 P1 plus 32, and then DF2 divided by DP2 is equal to 0.24 P2 plus 36. So they are given in the incremental cost for two generators. They are connected with this transmission line. So obviously there will be transmission losses. So we need to use the second method or second algorithm, right? So then what we need to find out, and also with P1 is equal to P2 is equal to 100 megawatts. So they have given the P1, P2 values also, and they have given DPL divided by DP2 is equal to 0.2. What is this? What is this? Any idea? So you are going to solve this. So tell me what is the value for L1. So we need to find out the penalty factor. So you are going to find out what is the L1 value. Make it fast. I'll give 2 minutes time. Let's check how many of you completing. Find out the penalty factor and tell me the values. Are you doing it? So here, what is given? Solution is given value ITL2 is equal to 0.2, and then from this I can find out L2 is equal to 1.25. And then by solving lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2, I will come up with the value of 0.16 into P1 is nothing but 100 plus 32 into L1 is equal to 0.24 into 100 plus 36 into 1.25. So I will get L1, this is L1, is equal to 1.5625, just for practice. Okay, so any doubt? It's just again a simple problem you may get in examinations. Any doubt in this problem?
No,
just same like previous case. Any doubt, please tell me.
No, sir.
Okay. So next question is problem 7. So problem 7, note down. I will ask questions, please note down. They have given you a diagram like this. So there are two generators connected like this. Assume this figure, and then so this is the question they are given. A two bus system shown in the figure. If 50 megawatt is transmitted from plant 1, this plant 1, then there is a transmission loss of 10 megawatts. Means in plant 2 there is no any losses because this at plant 2 only load is connected. So if any value is generated from plant 1, then there only losses will occur because there is no any load at plant 1, but from plant 2 only is there. So losses will occur during this transmission line only. So only for power generated at plant 1 there are loss. So how much loss? If 50 megawatt is generating, 10 megawatt is losses occur. So 40 only we are getting the load. Find the required generation for each plant and the received by the load when the system lambda is 22 rupees per megawatt. So if they are given the lambda value, system lambda value they are given. If this is the lambda value, then how much how much power you need to generate from plant 1 and plant 2 for the optimization you need to find out. And they are given the total cost function, so C value they are given. From this C value we will get ABC values. So from this ABC value and then lambda value we are going to find out the optimized scheduling of generator 1 and generator 2. So the solution, first write down the question I hope everyone write the question right. So the solution is what is B22? B22 is equal to 0 means the losses due to the plant B is 0, obviously 0. And then this is B matrix is nothing but loss coefficient matrix, right? So from this matrix, B matrix, we can take B22 as equal to 0. This is the first we are going to understand. And also losses between 1 and 2 or 2 and 1 is not there. Only for B11 will be there. So B12 is equal to B21 is also 0. So these things we need to understand from this question. Now from this figure. So this figure is very, very important, because in this figure we understand that at power plant 2 only the load is connected. That is, demand is from here only. And this is nothing but PG1 and this is PG2. And they have given the lambda value as this. So for this lambda, how much power will be generated in PG1 and how much power is generated in PG2 to meet the demand value, and also include the losses only because of this power plant 1. Because of that, I removed all the B22, B21 and B12 is equal to 0. So this is the first condition. Next, we know what is the power loss equation. We know that the power loss equation BL is equal to B11, we derived this B11 PG1 square plus B22 PG square plus 2B12 PG1 PG2. Here you can see we are having PG1 component here and then B22 here. So if you put 0, then this will be eliminated and this also will be get eliminated. Only these things will be there. So if that is the case, then finally I will get PL is equal to B11 PG1 square. And from question, I have understand that PL is equal to 10 and PG1 is equal to 50. So this is the given from the question. If that is the case, then I will find out the B11. So B11 is nothing but PL divided by PG1 square. So if that is the case, I will solve like this, 50 square, then I will get 0.004 is nothing but my B11. So I got the B11 value. If I got the B11 value, then now I can go for the what optimization required. So optimization required is nothing but to solve lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2 is equal to the lambda given in the question. How much value they are given in the question? Because we know that for optimization, lambda must be equal for all the plants. So it is nothing but 22 rupees per megawatt hour. So I'll tell this as 22. I'll make this as the 22. Now this lambda 1, lambda 2 values, to find out the lambda, then I need to calculate what are the things I need to calculate. So this lambda is nothing but, lambda value is nothing but IC1 divided by 1 minus ITL. So this is the generalized formula for this lambda. If that is the case, I need to find out IC1, IC2, ITCL1, ITCL2, then only I can solve this. So in other words, I will tell lambda 1 is nothing but IC1 divided by 1 minus ITL1 is equal to IC2 divided by 1 minus ITL2 is equal to 22. So then only I can able to solve. So first thing I need to find out is ITL1 is equal to nothing but DPL divided by DPG1. If you differentiate the loss equation with this, then I will get this. So we already solved that. This value is nothing but 2B11 PG1, because all other second B22 values are 0, so I will get only this value. And if you solve this, I will get 2 into B11 value, we know, and I know B, this PG1 value also, so I will get B11 is nothing but, so otherwise I will write like this, 2 into B11 value is 0.004, and then this is PG1. So this is from ITL1, and then for ITL2 is nothing but, this is also DPL divided by DPG2. So if that is the case, I will get 2B12 PG1, and this will be obviously 0, because this is the 0 component, so I will get 0 only. So this value is 0 entirely, because we are having B12, so obviously it will be 0. So I got ITL1 value, ITL2 value, and two things from the question we know. ICI value in general, 2CI PGI plus BI. So this is the generalized equation for IC. And then from question, we know C2C1 is equal to 0.02. From question, we can write now. From question, we know what is C value, and we know what is B value, and this is nothing but A1, B1, C1, and this is C2. B2, and then this is A2. So from this question, I know 2C1. 2C1 is nothing but 0.02. Just I'm multiplying that, because here it is 0.01. So if I multiply, I will get 0.02, and then 2C2 is nothing but 0.04, and then B1 is nothing but 16, and then B2 is equal to 20. So from this value, I can solve my IC1 and IC2. So for IC1, if you apply, I will get 16 plus 0.02 PG1, and then IC2, I will get 20 plus 0.04 PG2. So from question, and then from this generalized equation, I got IC1, IC2, and these two things, ITL1, ITL2. So from this input, I can solve this one. I can solve this one. So how to find out that? We know that lambda 1 is equal to 22. I can write like this, and then lambda 2 is also 22. Can I write like this? Any doubt? Any doubt? If that is the case, so lambda 1 formula is nothing but IC1 divided by 1 minus ITL1 is equal to 22, and then this is nothing but IC2 divided by 1 minus ITL2 is equal to 22. Why? Because the 22 is given in the question. And one more thing, we know that all the lambda values are equal. If that is the case, then definitely this lambda 1 is also 22 only, and lambda 2 is also 22 only. So from this, IC1 value just now we derived, that is nothing but 16 plus 0.02 PG1 whole divided by 1 minus, and this ITCL value also we have got, that is nothing but 2 into 0.004 PG1 is equal to 22. And then here it is 20 plus 0.04 PG2 whole divided by 1 minus 0, because this value is 0, is equal to 22. And if you try to solve this, you will get PG1 is equal to 30.612 megawatt, and then PG2 is equal to 50 megawatt. Just a minute. 50 megawatt. Okay, so if you find out, if you want to find out the PL transmission loss, then apply the value of B11, then we will get the PL value. So in question they are asking PL also, So what you have concluded is this is the optimized value. If you are operating our generator with this, then we will tell that this is the optimum value. And then to find out the PL, PL is equal to B11 PG1 square is nothing but 0.004 into P2. Just now we find out, apply that value, that is nothing but 30.612 whole square. So how much you are getting, just calculate this, and that is your PL. And then PD is nothing but PG1 plus PG2 minus PL. So you need to include this PL and then you will get the PD. Okay, so this is the demand they required. That is nothing but this is the demand which is required in this question. And we know what is loss and we know what is the optimum scheduling value. So from all the values we find out from this question. Any doubt? Any doubt in solving this problem? So you need
no sir.
You need to solve this and then you put that value here and then you will get the demand. Very simple, right? Next thing is we need to actually derive the transmission loss formula. So up to this, what we have taken the transmission formula, like in last problem also we solved. Okay, no problem. We need to derive the transmission loss formula. So that is very very important concept, and in syllabus, in your syllabus it is given. So I like that this. Derivation of transmission loss formula. So this derivation of loss formula is given by Cron, the author called Cron. He is the author who given this this method to find out the transmission losses, because it is too complex. Say for example, if this is the transmission line you are taking, and there is a generator here and there is a generator here, and if this generator is flowing here, then I will call as ID. ID means the total demand. Say these are all the demands we require. See, total demand. So total demand current is coming from only this generator if this generator is not on. And this is too complex, this transmission is too complex, deriving equation for this is too complex. So this Cron has taken so much time to derive this type of transmission losses. What he did, all these transmission lines he taken is into a single line called IP. So he converted all the transmission lines, and he said that the current flowing through this all transmission line is nothing but IP1. So if this is the case one, so he taken like, there is one more case, the same thing can be like this. Say a switch is here but this flowing here to the transmission system, so this is also possible. And here you can say the total demand is flowing from this generator only, and here also there is all the transmission lines are given in IP2, and there are load here called ID. So there are two cases. So maybe this generator may flow here or this generator may flow here. And one more condition is you may have like this. So all the transmission lines are given like this, and this is the total current with two generators, all these two generator is connected. And I will call this is the IG1, current flowing here is IG1, and this is IG2, the current flowing here is IG2. So if that is the case, then I will get this IP value. This IP value means this IP value is equal to 4 case 3 ampere. So this is case 1, case 2, and this is case 3. For this case 3, this IP value is nothing but MPIIG1 plus MP2IG2. Okay, so this is the equation I will come. And what is MP1 is nothing but IP1 divided by ID. That is nothing but the current flowing through this divided by ID. And this MP2 is nothing but IP2 divided by ID. So here the total is nothing but if you add this and this, then I will get the total power. So up to this I will stop, and in next class we will see how to derive. This is the just an input to observe the transmission lines mathematical formation. We will discuss in next class. Okay, attendance I will take. You just put your USN number in the chat box. I will take attendance from there. So up to this I will close this class and I will continue.